All right, guys, as many of you know, I made a huge computer switch last year from my Apple system to a custom-built PC, and I just want to make a quick video recap now that it's been about a year and give you an update. Let's do it. Now, I'll keep this as short as possible and try to cut to the chase here. My PC build has been absolutely great. It's truly been a long time since I was this impressed with anything. And coming from Apple and having been a die-hard Apple user for over 14 years, guys, beforehand, I was very concerned about making such a big switch. And so many people would tell me that I'm gonna be making a big mistake and told me how they hated Windows 10 and this, that, and the other, and all this stuff. Look, I too remember way back in the day when I used Windows at my old job, and I too hated it. I hated it. And I swore I would never deal with it again after I switched to Apple. Once I switched to Apple, I, like many others, instantly hated Windows. Again, this was 14 years ago. And from that day forward, I was telling everyone that I knew to switch to Apple. So I beg you all to please understand that I do not hate Apple at all. And I think they're an amazing, company. They make amazing machines and they get an A+ for many things. Don't get me wrong. But over time, both Apple and myself, we've slowly changed. Apple has focused more and more on iOS, favoring design over performance, along with kind of getting everyone to sort of just be a part of their, what I call, ecosystem. And myself, well, I've been a little bit more resistant and I very much favor more flexibility, power, and performance. And in the end, having a machine that I can really truly make mine just makes the most sense, okay? So, quick recap. Last year, I went to Apple to replace my then 8-year-old iMac i7, and once I sat down and really looked at the cost versus benefit, I decided to open my mind, do some research on what the other options were out there for me, and I decided to do something totally new, and I built my own unique system here, okay? So I did, and I'm really, really happy with it. That's the summary. It's that simple. Nothing wrong with Apple. Again, they make amazing products. I just wanted to do a bit more customization in terms of the attached drives, and I also wanted the ability to use some more aggressive hardware and just in general have a little bit more, a lot more, control over everything. Basically, I just wanted to build my dream system and have it be able to do all that I wanted it to do, both for business and for some fun stuff. And that's exactly what I did, and I love it. Now, Windows 10, I use the Pro Edition, has been absolutely rock solid. There have been zero issues. My machine, for the record, is on 24/7. It does not get powered down. It's rebooted about once a month on average just to clear everything out and to do a restart. This was actually the same pattern that I did with my Apple computer for years and years as well. The only updates that I've had to deal with are just some security updates here and there. And everything's been seamless with no issues whatsoever. And I've been closely monitoring my system and the CPU usage. Everything has just been perfect. Knock on wood, no issues. I have the OS set up for me just like I had when I had my Apple computer. And there's honestly not one thing that I miss or can't do now with Windows 10 that I could back with Apple. You know, in fact, some of the features that I was most worried about losing when I was with Apple was the expose, multitasking, and just the way that that would work, and also the live preview. And I'm happy to show you that right here in Windows 10, I have exactly the same process. I have my virtual desktops down here. I use 5 of them. I use this first one for my email. My CRM is over there. Desktop 2, I have as my dedicated internet browser where I can tab through different windows. I can drag and configure these any way that I want. And then tab 3, I have for production. So I can have my, I switched from Lightroom over to Capture One. I'm gonna be doing a video on that too shortly. But this just shows you I have this. And over here I have Photoshop. And then over here I can have Premiere Pro running. With the file manager if I need to load in assets. And even just like before, guys, on my old computer, if I just push the space bar, I can preview files and pictures and thumb through them just like I did before on Apple, and I really love that. And then over here, I have my fifth desktop, which I use just for like word processing, writing articles, scripts, things like that. So overall, this is absolutely amazing, and I'm not missing any of those core features that I was so accustomed to with Apple. And I could never go back to anything less now, truthfully. I really appreciate this operating system, and what I love about it most is that with Windows 10, it can be as simple or as complicated as you want it to be, and that's really great because it gives me the choice. With Apple, everything was a very closed down system, which for most people is a non-issue and likely a good thing, but again, in terms of being flexible and simply able to do whatever I wanted to do, this is now clearly the winner, no questions about it. The only change I made to it since I built it was the physical PC case. I did decide to get a new case for it. I started off with one that I thought would be really cool, and it was, but I just decided aesthetically to swap it out for this new one, which I found after the fact online, and actually reminds me of the good old days when I had my own Apple Mac Pro Tower computer, which to me personally was the best looking and best designed computer in the world at the time, maybe even ever. This new case that I have brings over some of those design elements of that older styling, and it's just absolutely beautiful in person. The camera does it no justice. It's solid aluminum, has killer ventilation, and is super easy to build inside of. To me, this is kind of the modern day Mac Pro, and if this had an Apple logo on the front of it and you saw it in the store with the specs that I have under the hood, this thing would be $15,000 or more. Basically, this is what I wanted. I wanted a current version of my old beloved Mac Pro Tower that I had back in the day. I wanted it to be able to do more than what OS X would allow for now that Apple is slowly kind of turning all their computers into big iPads. And at the same time, I got the absolute most for my money, spending only a fraction. So my review of this thing is nothing but stellar, and I would highly recommend to anyone else considering other options for their next upgrade. If you have questions or if you need help with a build, you can check out my parts list down below in the video description, and I of course will respond to most all comments that I get. For the record, I am not interested at all in any type of debate between the two computers. I don't believe that there is a winner here. It's all very personal choice. I dealt with this for weeks after my article and video was featured and went live last year on F-Stoppers, and I just don't care, and I don't have time to debate any of that, okay? This is just a recap to let you all know how I truly feel now that I've lived with this guy for a solid year. I'll see you all soon. Thanks so much. Go over camera settings. The number one thing is really consistency. Now, the physical placement of the light is important here. That's never gonna work. See, look at this. This is really cool. The problem is that all of her is facing that same direction. When you drop that chin, it builds that intensity. Now, I'm gonna take this shot. It's wrong. This is one of the things that I wanna change, but I'm gonna shoot it so I can show it, and then we're gonna change it. Stay like that. Exceed the building so that you're not introducing any highlights. There are no highlights. Turn your face more this direction like this. See that? There it is. It's all or nothing. So I wanted you in here first to see what I'm doing. So now we're gonna control this. So this is really a three light setup. You're having fun, right? So we're doing the breakouts now. We've got two groups we got going on here. Let me see. Dude, it's so sick.
Back you it think up. So, bro?
There, it's all coming together. That's what you want. We are totally pulling back the curtains here.
Well, let me tell you something. This is probably one of the best workshops I've been to.
Heidi Klum was supposed to come. I had her on speed dial. I said, Heidi, I got this workshop.